To help us see the need for caches, we'll examine this little snippet of code. From an application programmer's perspective, a statement like this one, the sum plus equals a of I, would seem to happen in one step. Even in assembly, it would only take a few instructions. In terms of time on the clock, however, not all of these instructions are the same. Sum, being a local variable, is most likely stored in a register in the CPU. Therefore, there is almost no cost to retrieving its value. A of I, however, is in main memory, and retrieving its value can take 100 CPU cycles. And even then, the bus bandwidth might only be able to pass back 2 bytes a cycle, or thereabouts, to get the data back. Trips to main memory are expensive, and this trend has only become worse over the past few decades with hardware advances. The solution to this problem has been to place a smaller, faster set of memory made with faster technology closer to the CPU. We call this memory a cache. And here, we are looking at a latency of about 10 cycles. So, when the CPU wants the contents of some memory address, it looks in the cache first. If it finds the data it needs, great, we just achieved a factor of 10 speedup. We call this a cache hit. If the data it wants is not in the cache, then we have to go to main memory. We call this a cache miss. The key is keeping these cache misses infrequent so that on average, time spent accessing is more like the time it takes to access the cache than it is like the time to access main memory.